So for us, it is a very, very important day that we can now convert the sewage sludge into briquettes, into the fuel which the people can use for cooking, and in turn reduce on charcoal use, and then in turn also help in protecting the environment. So we discussed this technology internally here, and we are happy to team up with Water for People, who are going to be majorly in charge of putting the infrastructure, and for us, we shall be in charge of giving them the resource, and also there will also be some joint activities.
We've spent over 3 years undertaking research on the safety, but also on this biofuel, and we are very confident that it's a better product than what is out there on the market. The briquette made out of faecal sludge is much better than the briquette you make out of 100% charcoal. So we are very confident that it's very safe because we carbonize it to a degree of over 300 degrees to kill all the pathogens. And we are sure that Ugandans can enjoy using the briquettes, especially the farmers or any household that is interested in something that is cheaper than the charcoal that is out there.
This is not a profit-making business. For us, our interest is a more sustainable way of dealing with this sludge. Because as I told you, this sludge, we've been converting it into manure. And as we convert it to manure, the people are cutting trees now to make charcoal. So we lose trees as we are just concentrating on manure, which is really not bringing us a lot of revenue. We don't get more than 100 million from this manure. So it will be an issue of marketing. How do we market it? How do we package it so that people feel that there is no problem using this byproduct?
Okay, in terms of investment, we've already invested close to $300,000 in this project, but we hope the investment to even double in the coming years. And of course, we are not looking at profits per se. We are a non-profit making organization. We are looking at reinvesting all the money from this business to work with KCCA to undertake emptying, especially in the informal settlements.